Good morning, Feast Binamanan, and welcome to Feast at Home. And I'd like to welcome everyone sa ating exciting excursion through the book of Matthew. Yeah, Matthew's Gospel. And we are still in our series, Side A and Side B. And we are already in Top 40, titled Marriage and Celibacy. Today's message, I want to preach it today. Wherever you are, serve there. Yeah. Ano to eh? It actually came from a popular quote, spoken by many gurus. You know, wherever you are, be there. Well, this original quote is about embracing the present moment. Yung pagtipong naguhugas ka ng no, when you're washing the dishes, hugas ka ng tinggan, hugasan mo, di ba? Kung nagluluto ka, magluto ka, sarapan mo, di ba? Kung naglilinis ka, siguraduhin mo malinis. Because why? Because we have to be aware. We have to be mindful, di ba? Be here and now. I believe most of our pain come from being trapped in two prisons. Yeah. The prison of the past and the prison of the future. And these are also called prison of regret or the prison of fear. Yeah. We're either meditating on our past failures or our future worries. Yeah. But if you want to have more peace in your life, you must walk out from these two prisons and enter present moment. Yeah. And today I want to take you one step further. Because you have to serve in your struggle. Wherever you are, don't just be there. Serve there. When God created you, He designed you to serve, and you will never experience deep fulfillment unless you follow your original design. Your joy will remain shallow unless you live a selfless life. And how should you serve? Well, I believe God wants you to serve in your present state. Yeah. Are you married? serve there. Are you in a difficult marriage? You love each other, but every day is a struggle, right? Difficult. Serve there anyway. Are you separated? Serve there, even with the pain. Are you separated from your spouse and you're living with a new partner? And you've got three kids with, you know, your three kids already with your ex and two with your present partner. But you cannot get married in church because your ex-wife does not want to help you to get the annulment. What should you do? Serve there, even in the craziness. Are you a widower or a widow? Serve there. Are you a consecrated celibate? Serve there. Are you single waiting for the right person? Serve there. Are you single for a long time now and tired of waiting? Serve there. Are you single and have accepted the possibility that you might be single for life? Serve there. Even during times when you're lonely. Married people get lonely too. Because life doesn't go as kung paano natin pinlano yan, di ba? Life is messy. And in the middle, no, but in the middle of the mess, serve there. Serve in the struggle, in chaos, the confusion, the conflict, the complication. Serve there. Let's all remember that we're in God's holy presence. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today I receive all of God's love for me. Today I open myself to the unbounded, limitless, overflowing abundance of God's universe. Today I open myself to God's blessings, healing, and miracles. Today I open myself to God's word so that I become more like Jesus every day. Today I proclaim that I am God's beloved, I am God's servant, I am God's powerful champion. And because I am blessed, I am blessing the world in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. This is real talk. Capture how Jesus thinks. Let's read our main Bible reading for today. And it is in Matthew chapter 19. Let's read. Some Pharisees came and tried to trap him with this question. Should a man be allowed to divorce his wife for just any reason? Verse 3. Na alam nyo, nung panahon na yun, during ancient Israel, merong ano, there was a, what do you call this? A raging debate. Yeah. Tungkol sa divorce. And, anong, you know, yung mga Pariseo, they wanted to, what? Gusto nila mabing weak si Jesus doon sa hot controversy nila. And ito yung sinabi, ito yung sinagot ni Jesus sa kanila. Haven't you read the scriptures? They record that from the beginning. God made them male and female. And he said, this explains why a man leaves his father and mother and is joined to his wife. And the two are united into one. Since they are no longer two, but one, let no one split apart what God has joined together. Now, here's a tip, Kapatid. Don't just observe his thoughts. Don't just observe Jesus' thoughts. Observe his thought process. How does Jesus think? Now, kapag ka, di ba, during Jesus' time, pag may, you know, pag may present sa kanya na medyo, like a muddy issue, he goes back to Genesis. No? Jesus goes back to Genesis, the first book of the Bible. Because in Genesis, we see God's original purpose. Now, when I'm, it's like this, when I'm in a messy, confusing situation, purpose clarifies the mess. And what is God's original purpose? Ask me what? God created man and woman as two parts of his image. Diba? Man and woman together are the Imago Dei.
Yeah.
Marriage was supposed to reflect God's unity to the world. Remember that God is a community. He is Father, Son, and Spirit. And so like God, marriage is supposed to be another community of love. From marriage's original purpose, divorce was not an option. Diba? Alam niyo, ito, natutunan ko to early in marriage. Nung ako, early in our marriage. No? Kami mag-asawa niyo, the biggest fight we ever had was what? It started very small. And tukol po sa, what's pera? When you're, nung bago kami. Well, we still fight about it sometimes. You know. Background. Yeah, background. My parents are what? My mom is a businesswoman and my father was a company man. Although, my father was Ilocano. Yeah. Sabi nga, kuripot. And my mom, parang niya, naka-gloves. Nasa loob. Lagay yung pen, yung gloves niya. Yan ang kahipit sa pera sa mami. Not because she was strict, but because she was always safe. So, I became one like them. Kuripot. Kaya, diba, lagi ko naiisip na minsan laging magastos yung sister wife ko. Yan, yan ang naiisip ko. Kailangan namin bumili ng grocery. Ang iniisip ko, magastos sa grocery. May kailangan akong bilhin mga necessities. Ang iniisip ko, magastos sa asawa ko. Ganun. So, before that, bago ko na bago yan, we went through that. Ganun kami mag-away. And we tried to settle them as soon, you know, asa, mabili. Kailangan matapos. I remember na nag-away kami, it's only one day na lumagpas na kami. Because I don't want to sleep with, I don't want to sleep over a fight. And also, nakatulong sa amin yung Lux. Yeah. Light it up, couples retreat. It was really a hard start for us kasi, we always fight about stuff. And I was very insensitive before. Yan. And, the way I think is different from how she thinks, and got clash kami. But as in 14 years of marriage, we have already developed a way on paano namin maayos yung gulo. So we never, when we fight, we try not to escalate it further, and try, and we watch our tongue or we think, I specifically tame my tongue not to say something na slalo pang makapagpasakit or makakasama loob. Let's continue with our Bible story. Now, Hillel's popular fans club. Yeah. The Pharisees, hearing that Jesus says marriage should never be broken, felt that Jesus was now kumbaga, nabingwit niya siya doon sa usapan. So, they launched their, kumbaga, eto na, may kasunod ng tanong. Then why, they asked him, then why did Moses say in the law that a man could give his wife a written notice of divorce and send her away? Verse 7. The Pharisees were quoting Deuteronomy. Yeah. Let's read it. Suppose a man marries a woman but she does not please him, having discovered something wrong with her, he writes a document of divorce, hands it to her, and sends her away from his house. Deuteronomy chapter 24, verse 1. Now, if Moses wrote this, then it seems God approves of divorce. And did you notice how horribly open-ended it was? It said that a man can divorce his wife if she didn't please him. Boom! What does that mean? No. In fact, at the time of Jesus, there were two schools of thought in this debate. See Rabbi Hillel and see Rabbi Shammah. Yeah, in dalawa na yan. See Rabbi Hillel, he taught that, you know, based on the passage, God allowed the man to divorce his wife for kahit anong dahilan, for any reason whatsoever. Diba? Kung madaldal yung asawa mo, pwede mo i-divorce. Parang gano'n. Kung malakas umilit, pwede mo i-divorce. Diba? Kung lagi sunog yung pagkain, pwede mo i-divorce. Diba? Ganun yung kay Rabbi Hillel. For any reason whatsoever, you can divorce your wife. And the other school of thought was si Rabbi Shammah. And he taught that a man cannot divorce his wife unless you catch her in adultery. Now, as you can expect, it was Rabbi Hillel who had a huge fans club. Diba? Ano ba yung original intention? This was how Jesus answered their question. Let's read it. Jesus replied, Moses permitted divorce only as a concession to your hard hearts, but it was not what God had originally intended. And I tell you this, whoever divorces his wife and marries someone else commits adultery unless his wife has been unfaithful. Now, ulitin ko na, if you're going through a messy situation, always remind yourself of purpose. That's what Jesus did. While the Pharisees were obsessed with laws, Jesus was focused on purpose. Like in the Beatitudes, he quotes the law but brings out the intent, the purpose, and the first principle behind the law. Now, let me paraphrase what Jesus said in the Beatitudes. You've heard the law, don't murder. But now, I tell you, call someone, you know, G-A-G-O, and you're entering the realm of murder. Ganun na. And you've heard, don't commit adultery, but now I tell you, if you fantasize having a relationship with the girl that's not your wife, you're also committing adultery in the heart. Now, why was Jesus focused on the purpose behind the laws? Ask me why. First principles exposes God's heart. Now, why have the laws there? Some Pharisees saw Deuteronomy as God's command to allow divorce. But Jesus saw this verse not as a command, but as a concession. It's a pastoral solution to a messy situation. It's not God's ideal. This tension, diba? Between Genesis and Deuteronomy, between the ideal and the practical, hanggang it continues to this day. It continues to this day. Now, I have modern examples of this. Can people in irregular marriages receive communion? That's the question. One day, a feaster asked me, my marriage broke down, you know, a long time ago, but for 7 years now, I've been living with another woman and I have 2 kids with her. We both love God. We serve at the feast together. I'm still working on my church announcement. Kaya lang, you know, hindi ako, we can't get married in church yet kasi nga hindi maayos yung announcement. The question was, can we receive communion? For a long time, the doctrinal answer has been no. But recently, Pope Francis has been reaching out these wounded individuals in his pastoral letter. He opened the possibility that some of these couples in irregular marriages may actually be living in grace and may be called to go back to the sacraments. But instead of giving a blanket answer, very wisely he sees each case as unique, and thus leave it to the discernment of the local bishops and his priests, so that they can shepherd, you know, what, you know, yung kung paano na nakilala yung mga couples, you know, to shepherds that actually know these couples. Nakakatuwa, you know, I love this because God doesn't just see groups, He sees individuals unique and different and beautiful. Kaya kapatid, are you in one of those messy, sticky situations? God sees you. He sees your mess, but He doesn't define you by that mess. Instead, He sees you as His beloved with beautiful gifts and divine purpose. Today, He invites you, wherever you are, serve there. Now, we need to close our Bible reading. And this is the other call, which is what? Celibacy. The conversation turns into an unexpected topic. Let's read. Jesus' disciples then said to Him, "If this is the case, it is better not to marry." Not everyone can accept this statement that Jesus said. Only those whom God helps. Some are born as eunuchs. Some have been made eunuchs by others, and some choose not to marry for the sake of the kingdom of heaven. Let anyone accept this who can. Verse 10 to 12. God calls us to different states of life. Some are called to marriage. Some are called to celibacy. Both, no. Parehas naman beautiful callings yan. We live in a world that's obsessed with romance and relationships. But in God's kingdom, single life is a valid call. And did you notice we're either called to be one or zero? If you're called to marriage, it's one. If you're called to celibacy, it's zero relationships. Now, in reality, both are impossible. Mahirap. You need the grace from the cross. Calvary happens so that He can give you the grace of the impossible. Kapatid, as we worship God, open your heart to this grace from Calvary. And may your prayers and dreams come true. Almighty Father, thank you for this wonderful message that you have for us. Thank you for all of the wisdom that you continuously give us. Lord, take away all our sins, Lord. Forgive us. Have mercy on us, Almighty Father. Thank you, Lord, for a week that you have given us. Sa lakas, mga biyaya, provisions mo sa amin, Lord. Matuloy namin yung hilingin, Lord. Protect us. Keep us away from harm. Keep us safe and healthy. For this coming week, you know me, Lord, lean on ng pag-iisip and peace in order for us to have a more productive and a better week ahead of us. Make us better children, better servants of yours. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. In the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. If you've been on that, I miss you all. Wherever you are, serve there. Yeah, let's all fire each other up and be better servants. God bless us all.
including your family, because they want to be with you, Lord. I want to be with you, wherever you are, Lord. Wherever you are, take us with you, Lord. Lord, wherever you are, wherever you're going, take us with you, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you for taking us with you, Lord.
My heart is yours. Take it all. My life in your hands.
Without end.